A capacitor is basically like a short-term rechargeable battery. It's like a battery that can be quickly charged up and just as quickly discharged. And I can demonstrate that for you here. On this power supply, there's a large capacitor right here on this board. And I can charge this capacitor up by connecting it to this battery. And charge this guy up. It's now fully charged. It only takes a fraction of a second to charge the capacitor. Now, when I connect the lamp to it, what you'll see is the lamp will glow shortly and then for a short time and then dim out as the capacitor discharges. Here, let me just do it one more time. Charging up, discharging. Capacitor charging up, discharging. And actually, if I don't charge it through the lamp, if I charge it just directly off the battery, that's all it takes. Just a fraction of a second will completely charge the capacitor. So a capacitor is like a very short-term rechargeable battery that can be quickly charged up, but will also just as quickly discharge. Now, if you look at your capacitor, you will see that it is polarized. That is, there's a positive lead and a negative lead. And generally, the negative lead is marked on the side. You'll see like a little minus sign. Sometimes this is an arrow like that. Okay, can you see it on your little capacitor that you have? I can show it to you. Well, here, I'll show you another one up closer. See, this is the minus side here. If I back up just a little bit here, get a better look at it. That's the negative side. The positive side is not marked, but there's a negative side. And you'll also notice that the positive lead is the longer of the two. You notice that one lead's longer than the other, and the positive lead is the longer of the two. That's so you can identify the capacitor from the bottom of the board. When you have it mounted on a board, you can look at the bottom and see which side's the positive end and negative end. And that's real important because if you connect the capacitor backwards, it will blow up. Not maybe sometimes kind of blows up, not blows up, you know, a little bit. It really blows up. It blows the heck up. Yeah.
Demonstration.
No, not demonstration. Not for now. But it's real important that you connect these properly. I'm always very paranoid when I'm working on with capacitors. Make sure that you get it in there properly. Because what's inside these capacitors is a couple of sheets of aluminum foil separated by some brown paper. And the paper soaked in something called electrolyte. Say, Jeff, you got your tools there. Grab a pair of dykes so that I can cut one of these things open. I don't happen to have a pair with me. Danke. I'm going to cut this one open so you can kind of see what's inside. Kids, don't try this at home. In the bottom of this thing is like a rubber plug. Pop.
There it is.
And here's what's inside. Let me just show it to you up close on the camera here. Smell! If you look inside, here it is all rolled up. Now, let me just take the tape off here. Yeah, it was really important, Mel. You blew it. Okay. And let me just hold this out here so you can kind of see what it looks like. And I can unroll this paper.
Wait a minute,
Well, here, you big babies. here's the paper, and the what you see here is these two sheets of aluminum foil, and separating them is this paper soaked in something called electrolyte. The electrolyte is like the, you know, in your car battery, you know, the acid, that's electrolyte. Or in a dry cell battery, if you've ever seen a leaky dry cell, the stuff that's leaking out is electrolyte. Technically, what electrolyte is something that allows something called an ion to migrate. I don't know exactly what I'm talking about even. I don't care, because all I know is that if you hook these things up backwards, they blow up and send little bits of paper and foil all over the place. It just gets all over everything, and this makes a big mess. My high school electronics teacher told me of a guy, they nicknamed him Boomer because he was always putting these things in backwards. So be careful. Now this stuff, this electrolyte, ooh, it really stinks like hell, and it's all over my hands now, and it kind of burns a little bit. And it's, so you should be careful with these things. You're not really supposed to pull them apart. But that's what they look like inside. And as I mentioned before, and as I demonstrated, basically they're like a short-term rechargeable battery. These capacitors are called electrolytic, L-Y-T-I-C, electrolytic capacitors. There are many different kinds of capacitors, but the type that we're mostly concerned with is the type that fails the most. Since if something never fails, I may never even tell you about it, because I don't care. If it doesn't fail, I don't care what it is or what it does. But the electrolytic capacitors do fail a lot. It's a very common failure, and I'll tell you more about this in just a little bit. And it's especially common in monitors and power supplies. We see a lot of capacitor failures. When a capacitor fails, sorry, let me back up a little bit.